I'm back. Mazion, I said I'm back, man. Why won't you talk to me? Why is Tonnage looking at you like he's going to eat you?
I saw you poop on me.
What is up, the world? I didn't even do that poop. It's your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some Ark Survival Evolved on the Pooping Evolved server. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. The rain makes it slippery. Also, we mentioned this a couple of days ago, actually, or yesterday, me and Maz did. You can't fill up water bottles, I don't think, anymore underneath the structure. I think this is part of the acid rain update, stuff and things. That's kind of interesting information. Yeah, so anyway, all right, so tidbit aside, hope you guys are having a great day. I'm having a really good day. Thank you guys so much for coming back to join me for another episode of the Ark Survival Evolved Stuff and Things. And what else? Oh, yeah, thank you guys so much for all your likes and support, great comments, and just kind smiles. I really do appreciate it, guys. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and show your support. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe for more stuff and things. So today, we're going to be getting together with Mazion again to do some building this time. You know, back a long time ago, this is an unfortunate spot to be in. I'm just going to say, but we're going to risk it, okay? Because something terrible could happen right now at any moment. But we're just going to risk it right here. We're on the business end of Pugly. Pugly's business end is not the end you want to be on. Long ago, when we were first building Poop City, I built a little thing, and it was like a placeholder for a tower. And I wanted to build a purely aesthetic type tower thing just to have a tower in the city so it kind of looked like a city thing. And kind of put it off and never really did it. And I was talking to Maz about it and I said to Maz, we should build a tower thing that we put off years and years ago or possibly a month ago. And he said, yeah, let's do it, man. So we've been getting all sorts of materials together. Now I wanted you to take a look at all the stuff and things we've got. I've got some stone ceilings. Maz has a bunch of stone stuff he made. I got some storage boxes, you know, for stuff and things, some electrical outlets, a bunch of omnidirectional lights, a couple jennies, a bunch of wire, a bunch of gasoline. I'm kind of getting the technical stuff down. He's built a bunch of the building supplies that we're going to need as well. And up inside of here, I do believe I've got some more lights. And that was it. So, yeah, any hoozle. All right, let's see if we can safely get off. Slow mobility. Don't take fall damage. Don't take fall damage! It was a very small amount. It was an acceptable loss. All right, we're going to pop these guys inside of here. I think we should be good. Maybe I'm going to end up building a couple more. Let's get a bunch of thatch going here. I'm going to build a couple more ceilings because I think those are some things that we're going to need. Probably going to need about 50. He said he's got a couple hundred walls, a couple hundred ceilings going. So I'm going to grab a little bit more. How's my weight looking? Where is my weight? There it is. 180. 230. 280. 330, I could still move, and then we can grab a bunch of stone. And I think actually for logistical reasons, I'm gonna move. This is the, I can't even show you. This is the hide and fiber vault, and that's the stone and thatch vault. And I'm gonna interchange those, because this is a bad, I'd rather have, you gotta have your wood and thatch next to your stone, or it's just not gonna work out for you in life. So let's see here, C-E, oh yeah, spelled it right. And then we'll craft 11 more. Then we will gamma down, because it's becoming daytimes. And I will come, oh no! I will come over here like this. Okay. So we're building some stuff and things. It's going to be amazing. Let's go over to Poop City and meet Mazion and have some stuff and things happen. BRBs, peeps. All right. I'm going to count it down. Okay.
Okay.
On three. Three. And we're back. And we're inside of a pillar because Ark. With Mazion. What's up, man?
What's up, dude?
Much, man. You know, this is the spot. You can see the sign. I was telling my peeps that I had set the sign up when we first started Poop City. And this is the sign. It says future site of the tower thing, which is what we're going to build today.
I'm so excited. It's going to be big.
It's going to be amazing. Now, have you ever built a tower thing before?
Yeah, I've built some towers.
But have you built a tower thing? I mean, really?
Not a tower thing. No.
It's quite a bit different, I think.
Okay.
Also, I miss my base. There's a little bit of... It gets a little framey over here in Poop City.
Yeah, we built a lot of stuff in here, and now we've got the wild dinos spawning in too, so that's going to be a little bit of an FPS loss.
Yeah, they changed some of the spawning stuff, so we're getting some wild dino spawns in here. But all right, so you brought a bunch of stuff and things. We probably could just start building right off of this foundation here, but we were thinking you want to try to go, we were talking about it, what would it be, hexagon-shaped? Where did you go? Where are you?
I'm right here. I was by my bird, Airhog.
You want to go hexagon-shaped?
Yeah, it sounds like a plan to be something different, not just a regular squarish, boring tower.
Yeah, not just a square thing. We'll do something maybe a little bit more advanced. So, all right, I got some ceilings right here. So I'm thinking, like, one of them. You know, we'll start it off. There's no sense in hesitating.
Do Whoa. It.
Like so. Dude, we've pretty much done it almost to start
wow.
with. This is amazing.
The square.
It's a square, but we need it to not be a square. Now, did you make... Actually, I didn't make any. Did you make any foundation, fence foundations?
I did make... Oh, no, I didn't make any fence foundations. No, okay, I made fences.
We're going to need fence foundations to get the diagonal thing to happen. All right, so I have to build that. All right, but we got a solid start, man. We got a solid start. I'm pretty excited about this.
Got them pillars? Are we going to do it just the 3x3, or is it going to be 4x4 or 5x5?
We probably could just go like this to start with and get these pillars down in the corners. And then I think we're going to need to build some fence foundations and like lay out the basic bottom part of the tower design and make sure we've got the hexagon, and then we'll probably BRBs, man.
Sounds like a good deal.
All right. BRBs, peeps! And we're back. Not building a hexagon or an octagon, which is actually what it was supposed to be. Would have been an octagon. But we've made some decisions. Right, Mazion?
We did. It looks like we're going to do a 3x3 box. We went over and checked out what Miola had done, because he did that octagon way over on the other side over there.
Yeah.
And it takes some jerry-rigging and some finagling to make it happen.
Yeah, it's one of those things where I think with this build being so visible, like, I don't know, it's hard to explain. Like, with it being taller and stuff like that, it just kind of wasn't going to work out. We would have ended up having to put some, like, spaces in it. You can see, like, right there, Miola's got a space, and right there, and, like, it just doesn't work out. It's kind of complicated, but it just doesn't work out. But we have a cool design anyway. I think it's a cool design that we've thought about. Did you think about it?
I did think about it, and I think it's going to be neat. We're going to have a multi-layered system where we've got multiple walkways you can come out on, and it's going to be very tall.
I think it'll be really cool. I think we're going to go 4, 7, 8, 9, 10 tall.
Something like that.
Yeah. And then, did you bring windows with you, man?
I did. And walls.
We went back and did a ton more building of stuff and things. And so you got a little bit of hot window action, or you got it right there?
Oh, you want me to grab the windows? They're on this pump weight right here. I'll grab some windows.
Okay.
Put some back so you can grab some. I'm too heavy.
Okay. You got them right here. You know, you made ramps too, right?
I did. They're on the other pump weight.
Oh, good. Perfect.
Under here.
All right. The first things first. We need some hot ramp action on this piece, man, so we don't have to jump up and down here every time.
That's good thinking.
So I'm thinking, look at this. Nailed it! Ace it can't be stopped.
Wow, a ramp!
It's perfect. And then for windows, do you like it like right here, man? Like where, like right in the center? We'll do like a window here and a window here and a window on that side too?
Yeah, I'm thinking that would be good. And we probably should do some windows in between each walkway. That way it will be kind of like a, you know, as it goes up, they'll be in the center.
All right, like a so. And then we got walls, right? We got to get a bunch of walls. So the first layer piece here is going to be 4 high, right? That's what we said?
Well, yeah, we said we'd try it out and get the 4 high.
Try the 4 high. I'm going to get some walls as well. Why don't we build up this first layer and see what we can see?
Oh. Put a wall on the outside.
What? Where?
Out there. It went through the window.
You went through the window? Oh, it's perfect. It's too bad we couldn't make him, like, pop up like this for defense.
Right?
Yeah. All right. We'll break this one down. So we got two high. And then what about another window in the center on
this
layer?
That's what I was thinking. Yeah.
You like that? You like that?
You like that?
You like that? And then a window up there. And then one more layer is our fourth layer.
That problem we were talking about has occurred.
Oh, where it places. Okay.
Right here, buddy.
Yeah, man. You should tell people about this, because this is one of the frustrations of the building process that you have to overcome.
So anybody who watched me build my loft, I was having this problem. And whenever you have a floor that is, you're trying to build a wall between two floors, which are ceilings or vice versa on top, there's two snap points, one to this side and one to that side. And conversely, there's also where you can move it in either direction, facing in or out. So it gets confusing, but you can't press E to fix this problem. All you can do is replace it until it is flush with this one side.
Yeah. So basically, there's a snap point on the edge of this ceiling, and there's a snap point on the edge of this ceiling, and they're off by a little bit. Oh, yeah. Now, if you can see, I can actually show you, like, right here is the snap point for that, the far ceiling, and right here is a snap point for the close ceiling. So there, that should be better.
I think it is.
Like a so, and like a so. Nailed it. It's the campstop.
That's right. Now it shouldn't be messed up for the rest of the build because we have no more ceilings to deal with.
Yeah, so that should be good. So then, what?
We didn't make hatches.
We need to make some hatches. Yeah, we do. I actually probably have enough stuff to make. I can make a hatch frame. I can make two hatch frames. All right, so I got a couple hatch frames coming. So now we got to pick where the hatch frame goes and kind of get a couple more levels going. You want to just do a little bit more and then come back? Show the peeps?
Sounds like a plan.
All right, BRB's peeps. That is how we do. Do-do-do-do, just do stuff and things, man. Do-do-do-do, and stuff and things, man. I'm out, can't stop doing stuff and things, man. Burning the squirt, Chloe, come now that ace that can't be stopped. Do-do-do-do, just do stuff and things, man.
Completed.
We have made a thing. It is a thing. Hope you guys like the montage. Are you gonna do a montage?
I did a montage.
Hope you guys like the montage. Make sure to hit the thumbs up button if you thought it was cool. It came out interesting. It's kind of a pagoda-ish. It's a tower for sure, and it's humongous. And
really big.
I think it's cool, man. I really like it. It was like, you know, it's a thing. I really wish that you could, like, I don't know. There's part of me that wishes that some things were a little bit easier, especially with doing the diagonals and stuff like that. It's just the building system is really difficult with that stuff. So, it's too bad that wasn't able to be a thing, but I do like the way that this came out. Your air hog is all over the place, man.
Animals have been weird, dude. Like,
none of my animals do this stuff.
What is he doing?
What is your animal doing? Is it on follow?
No, he's not on follow.
Yeah,
he
was on follow.
No, he's not.
When I whistled him to not follow, he stopped doing it.
Oh, did you press U?
I pressed Y. Is it not follow? And he stopped following me.
Well, that's weird. I mean, it wasn't set on follow, so.
It is really weird. There's a bug. Mm. We found one.
Hey, it's been happening a lot lately.
All right. So the next portion of our adventure is placing the electrical stuff and things. Nail the days that can't be stopped.
Quote.
We have placed the generator. Now, I have a little bit of electrical wire, and I'm thinking, I don't know what you think, but this is what I think. Somebody just pooped. It was me. I'm thinking wiring right up the center like this is probably our best bet. See what I'm saying?
Yeah, looks good, man.
Just right up like this.
So then a junction box will go there so that the wires are kind of hidden by the floor on the next level, or?
I think, yeah, we could try that. I don't think that's a bad idea at all, man. I'm hoping.
Food.
You're out of food? I'm hoping the lights can all reach from a single junction box, but I don't know if that'll work either. I hope it will. I would love it to. So we
all of the lights?
Yeah, from the single junction box, maybe. All right, so we got a junction box right there, right?
Right.
Are there going to be any lights on this bottom level?
Probably should be. Are we going to do them in or outside?
I'm thinking outside.
Yeah.
All right, so we need lights on this level too, which means we need power. Do we need power to go underneath? Could we fit the... Oh, gosh, now we've already built the generator. We couldn't really fit the Jenny underneath. We could fit it over here, but it would be weird. Like, it wouldn't be centered.
Right.
So, did you leave the ceiling? Is that the just-in-case ceiling?
That was the just-in-case ceiling. You can destroy it now. I don't think we're going to do anything.
I don't know. Just in case. You always leave one ceiling in case you need to build out from it again. But, all right. So, let's just take a look here. Do you want to come up on the second level, and then we'll have a look at where the lights will go?
Sure. Do you have any food so I won't pass out?
I have a little bit. I don't have very much.
I just won't run around.
There you go. We can grab some more food.
Thank you.
For sure. So I'm thinking if we take our lights and like... Ready?
Ready.
Oh, perfect.
So we're going to place them like that.
Now, did it wire up is the question. Yes, this one did. Okay.
What about this one?
Yes, it did. Now, the back ones are the ones that are going to be the question. I don't think these are going to work. But, whoa. I'm a little bit laggy over here.
It's powered.
Oh, nice! Let me turn my gamma down a little bit here. There we go.
What's this too?
Yeah, these all powered up from that one junction box, dude, which is baller. Like, super baller that it worked out that way. That makes things a lot easier as long as all of our wiring. Now you see this junction box is going to have to be like there. So that's not bad. It's like in the floor, right?
Right. But then we tiered the layers on the above this so that they're shorter. So that'll be,
it'll be interesting.
The test.
It's going to be a big test. I'm just happy to find out that all these darn lights like will work. You know, it'd be cool if we could get, like, half sections of wire. That would be, like, much, much helpful.
Yeah, they should definitely add that to the game so that you can vary your distances for sure.
A little bit. I just want to go down the ladder. I'm just going to fall to my death. I don't care. All right, so we need a couple more junction boxes, it looks like. I happen to have built some.
Feet. Oh.
So, you know, something I think we would talk about a little bit is I was hearing you doing a couple of vlogs, and a lot of people ask you about me and your vlogs.
Tons and tons of questions about you.
I know. But you know what I think is kind of sad is that when I did a vlog, I was expecting some questions about you, and no one asked me questions about you. And I felt kind of sad. Cause what? Why can't? Oh my gosh! This should be easier to climb up a ladder. Like I just want to climb up a ladder and I want to get off the ladder and on that floor, but it's like impossible. It's so impossible to do.
I'll go up all the way. You come up, shut the door, go down, then we'll be good.
Oh, I did it by falling. I pro-falled.
Can you shut the door?
Wait, what door? This one?
Yeah.
All right, come on down, man.
Hey, thanks.
Nailed it. All right, so. What are some of the questions that people ask you about me?
What is it like being Slipgator's brother?
So I should answer the question then, what is it like being Mazion's brother?
I suppose.
Because I want to flip the script, man. I think that's a cool people's term, but I wanted to try to use it. So,
well, you do it.
You know what? I think with this one, we're going to make it a little bit ugly. Oh, no. That would be... This could possibly be very ugly. Let me just break that guy. And then we'll do another junction box here. And then up there. And then... I can't see it. All right. So what's it like being Mazion's brother? That's the question. It's like pretty much like being anybody's brother. I don't really notice anything different about it from... I don't know. How do you even answer that question? What does that even mean?
Yeah, the questions generally get, kind of vague answers.
I fell.
Are you dead?
No, I survived it magically.
Well, good. A lot of questions, too, are like, do you hang out with your brother a lot? And I'm like, yeah, you know, on Christmas, because we live in different states.
Because we live in different states, yeah.
Stuff like that. That's weird. So one of those is getting hit by the junction box on the bottom. This one right here.
It's getting hit by it? Oh, it's like double wired.
But just that one.
So we can't get down. I can't get down to this level. All right. How about we do this? I'm going to climb up. Can you close that door above you?
I can close it below me, too, I think.
No, that's what I mean. Can you go below and then close it from below?
So that I can't come up?
Yeah, so that I can get down. I can't close it. All right, now I have to duck. Now you can come up. Oh, my gosh.
Oh,
nailed
complicated.
It. Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. Yeah, we live like hundreds of miles away from each other, so we don't really get a chance to hang out all the time because of distance. Okay, I've trapped myself with the light.
I did the same thing.
What are we supposed to do? You know, if you jump on that railing, man, it's gonna flip you off. Not like flip you off, but like flip you off.
Oh, I got past.
Oh, you got past the wrong way though, because there's no door there. You can't climb through the window.
There's a window.
Oh, I got past.
All right. Nice.
I think I should be able to go like this.
Oh. Ow.
Did you fall?
I did.
There, I got that one placed. Now we can go like this. And then if you build, also guys, if you build a railing on a one high, you have to duck. The railing makes it so you have to duck to get out, which is kind of a pain in the butt. All right, we've got all the lights, man. I think they're all up. Whoa, door to the face.
That was not helpful.
Door to the face. To the face, to the face. Tabe reference, check. Old school YouTubers will know what that is. Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. So, did you bring any gasoline?
You brought gasoline.
I did bring gasoline. What other kind of questions do people ask you?
They ask, like, what our interactions were like as children. Like, were we good brothers to each other? And,
Yeah, we were pretty good.
Yeah, you know, I'm like, we're brothers. We had brother things, but besides the brother things, everything was great.
Yeah, it was pretty good. Like, it wasn't bad. Did your brother beat you up, and was he awful and terrible, and did he cut your hair off? There's some funny stories, man. There are some funny stories.
Do you remember the funny stories?
I remember some really funny stories.
I don't remember all the funny stories.
I don't want to tell embarrassing stories, though, but I do know some. So the sunburn, the infamous sunburn.
Oh, yeah.
You should tell people that was good. Yeah, that was some good stuff.
Sure, we'll tell the story.
You want to tell the sunburn story? All right.
I'll tell the sunburn story. So when I was a child, probably I was a tween, and I decided
you were
that
young.
It was,
you were
yeah,
young.
I was a tween. I was like between 10 and 13.
Yeah, something like that. I was thinking you were like 12. I think that. Yes.
Yeah. I decided it was cool to... What's up?
Do you want to turn the lights on?
Turn them on! I decided it would be cool if I shaved my head with a razor, so I did that, you know? And then I also wanted to go play volleyball with everybody.
Should I tell him about what it looked like when I came out of my bedroom and you were in the bathroom shaving your head with a razor when you were 12?
Sure.
All right, so I don't want to tell embarrassing stories, but you're 12. You didn't know. But, yeah, so I get up, and my bedroom door is, like, directly across from the bathroom. And I wake up, and Maz is in the bathroom, and he's 12, and he's standing in front of the mirror, and he's got shaving cream and blood all on his head. Like, and there's a couple places, Maz, where it was, like, dripping. Like, it was, like, a blood, little blood drips. Like, not a lot, right. Not like a big cut, but you had cut your head from shaving your head. And so I get out, and I just remember, like, getting up, and, like, it was early, and I opened the door, and that's what I saw, and I was like, what are you doing? And you were like, I'm shaving my head. It was kind of funny.
Right.
All right, so there.
And you were, like, 17, and I was 12, so.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, so then I went out in the sun and played volleyball with my brother and all of our, the posse. Which
the family, yeah, then. Family, friends, and stuff.
And I was out there for about 8 hours and played volleyball and did some other things on the outside. And then the next morning when I woke up, my head had blown up to the size of an alien head.
It was crazy.
Like the classic alien that you see with like the slanty, eyes and, you know, the gigantic brain.
It started off with just your head. Basically you had got a sunburn so bad.
Yep.
That it had
all
like
the capillaries in my head burst.
Oh God!
That's what they told me. All the capillaries in my head burst, and then I actually I had to take steroids to make the swelling go down. But like he was about to say, it started off on the top, and then the gloop like created a bubble that descended around like to my Neanderthal eyebrow area and like neck and eyeballs.
It basically drained into your face.
Yeah, it was amazing.
It was really amazing.
It was amazing.
It was crazy. But you survived it.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, you know what we gotta do? We gotta go turn all these lights on now.
The default
state is off. But you survived it. But that, see, I didn't want to do an embarrassing. That's kind of, it's not really embarrassing, but it was amazing.
We've never seen anything like it since.
I've never seen it anything like it ever. And I don't think we ever will, because it was just crazy. And the thing that I remember that was so crazy about it is that it didn't seem like your head was that red. Like, I don't remember it being sunburned. I just remember it being swollen.
Yeah, me either, to be honest. Yeah, the capillaries thing. I don't know if it required my head to actually get a sunburn or what the deal was.
Ah! Did you get them all?
I turned on the ones on the top. I was trying to get to the pain in the butt.
Oh, here.
There.
Go up, and then I'll shut the door for you. There, now get down.
Well, that's not the pain in the butt layer.
Well, did you get this layer yet?
I don't know.
Probably not. Let's do this one then.
Trying to shut this. There we go. So I can do the most pain in the butt layer.
There's just no way that you can jump off these. It's so silly.
I don't remember very many embarrassing slip gator stories that don't involve having a lot of a good time.
Oh yeah, that's that. There are some of those, but that's probably best left. We don't need any of those stories. But I'm trying to think of a good one. Like, I don't know. I don't want. That's why I didn't want to do embarrassing stories, because I didn't want to have to. I didn't want to do that.
It's okay.
But
don't mind.
I'm trying to think of a good one.
About you?
Yeah, I don't know. One that's, like, age-appropriate. Oh, did we do lights on the bottom level here?
Thought we did, but maybe not. No, we did not.
So do we need them in the same spot, like...
I don't know.
And do they wire?
Yeah, that one did.
Oh, it did. It wired all the way up to that thing.
This one did as well. That one did as well.
All right.
It's really bright here now, and my gamma is normal.
It is really bright. You know what we got to do next, man, is we got to wait for night and show this place off at night.
For sure.
All right, let's wait for night, and then we'll be RBs, peeps. And we're back under cover of night. And the big reveal It looks awesome with that purple beacon behind it.
Right?
That's like amazing. Let me see if I can get over here and get like a screenshot of that. Oh, that's cool looking. It looks really cool, man. I like the way that it turned out.
Yeah, it's pretty neat.
I think it's great. Oh, I'm freezing.
We talked about it way back when we first started the season that we were going to do this, and finally we got it done.
Yeah, finally. It came out pretty good. You were saying the top level you thought could be one higher?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A little bit taller.
Yeah, I think I agree with you, man. I think that would have been a good call, but I think we're out of materials and we're out of time for today, so maybe another day.
Agreed.
But thank you very much for hanging out, man, and helping doing the building and stuff. I had a good time hanging out.
Ditto, yeah, lots of fun. We did a little bit of skeet shooting, and you, like, yelled at me and pooped on me. And
that's right, yeah, that's right. I was like, what? Oh, yeah.
Good times.
All right, it was cool, man. It's a good tower. It turned out great. I'm really glad we did it. I think it was fun. All right, I'm going to pop down here and land.
It's really bright.
It is really bright. The lights are very bright. We could gamma down to, like, gamma 1. There.
Oh, perfect.
But now we can't see anything.
My bird is as black as the sky.
It looks pretty terrible with Gamma 1. All right. So that's going to be it for today, peeps. If you guys like the video, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit.
Be excellent to each other.
And may the stuff and things be with you.